Hello viewers, today's topic is the extension program planning. Extension means behavioral changes of the individuals, and behavioral consisting of the knowledge, the skill, the attitude and understanding. There are four components of this behavior. If the all components are being changed, then only we can say this is extension education. This comes under the social sciences, and there are certain programs and planning. Program is consisting of four elements: analysis of the situation, fixing the objectives, identify the problems and find out their solutions. That is a program. And planning, a systematic approach through which our program to be implemented in the villages, that is a extension program planning. The meaning of program planning, the process of bringing about planned change. There are certain type of the changes are there, but we must have a systematic change among the rural masses. Program can be implemented in such a way, there must be a systematic change can be arose among the farming community. A deliberate and collaborative process involving change agent and client system at grassroots functionaries for which the program is to be made, which are brought together to solve a problem, or more generally to plan and attain a improved state of functioning in the client system by utilizing and applying valid knowledge. Knowledge abundantly available in the remote areas, but how best we can enhance the grassroots functionary so that they can change their attitude, change their behavior, change their knowledge in such a way that the whatever programs are there that can be easily be understandable by the clientele system. A total educational job being done in a particular setting, a statement issued to promote understanding and interest in an enterprise. Education also play a very important role for developing the knowledge infrastructure. Systematic setting of the knowledge provided in such a way, there must be a skill development among the rural masses. Then only when we can say that promote the understanding and interest in the enterprises. Which enterprise would you like to deliver to the farming community? There must be a systematic development of this program. Program can be prepared in such a way that can be based on need and interest of the farming community, and therefore we can have to promote the understanding and interest in the enterprises in which the grassroots functionary clientele system is to be interested. The program planning is a decision making process. Certain program has been launched in the village area, but sometime farmer accept that program, sometime farmer reject that program, and therefore we can call it as a decision making process involving a critical analysis of existing situation. We must analyze the situation of a particular village, whether the situation is congenial for implementation of this program or there are certain obstacles they come in across with us, it is very difficult for us to promote the program, and therefore existing situation must be analyzed. Then when before implementation of the program, there are certain problems can be arose in the villages. Number of problems can be arose. Then we have to identify certain problems. Evaluation of various alternative to solve this problem. There are certain problems are there, but we have to find out what are the alternative resources, how we can solve this problem in a systematic manner, and therefore alternative solution can be chalked out with a view to facilitate the individual and community growth and development. We can solve the problem in such a way, there must be a alternative solution to facilitate the individuals and community growth and development in the rural areas. There are certain extension scientists, there are certain stalwarts in the field of program planning and extension education. They have given some a very specific definition of the program planning according to Kilsey and Hierney. Kilsey, according to him, a defined extension program is an statement of situation, objectives, problems and solution. It is relatively permanent, but requires some constant revision. It forms the basis of extension plan. In the beginning, I have narrated that the program planning consisting of four elements: analysis of the present situations, what type of situation is prevailing in the area for which the program has been chalked out and would like to implement this program, and there are certain objectives has been chalked out. There are two type of the objectives in the program planning. One is an informative, another is an persuasive. Your objective is just to pass on the information to the farming community, that comes under the informative, whether the farmer can understand or not understand, but my job is to provide the information in a systematic manner, that is a program informative. Another objective is an persuasive. My objective is to persuade the farmers, persuade the client system in such a way that whatever I know, that must be transferred to the farming community in a very systematic manner, that is comes under the persuasive. In extension program planning, persuasive objectives plays a very important role for development of end user. Almost all the program must be relatively permanent, but requires some constant revision. Program must be permanent in nature. We have to fix up the program, but in case of exigency, in case of unforeseen circumstances, in case of unquermiment, we must have some provision of revision of this program in a systematic manner. It forms the basis of extension plan. If we all the program, all the statements can be clubbed together, according to Kilsey-Hierney, program plays a very important role if we club together for the situation and plan the program in a very systematic issues. Then another stalwart in the field of extension education is a Ligon, J. Paul Ligon. According to J. Paul Ligon, says that it is a set of clearly defined, consciously conceived educational objective. Objective must be clearly defined and consciously conceived each other, but they must have some educational nature also. That type of objectives are there in the program planning, and derived from an adequate analysis of the situation, these objectives are derived from after a thoroughly study of the situations, then only we can find out the objective which are to be achieved through extension teaching. Sir, teaching, extension teaching is a process in which we can pass over technology by public speaking, by various methods of teaching. In extension teaching, there are so many of the methods. Sometime it is an auditorial method, sometime with the help of audiovisual education, sometime we can have a mix up with the real and virtual extension education. So many of the extension education methods are there through which we can achieve the success of this program, according to Ligon, say like this. There are certain principles of program planning. Every program planning needs certain principles. The extension program should be based on analysis of past experiences, present situation and future need. Any program seems to be a successful only when we can find out the past experiences. So many of the program of far-reaching significance before independence, after independence, until today has been launched by the government, but there are certain past experiences about these programs. We must take care about the past experiences about these programs. Then now, what is present situation? Present situation seems that so many of the programs already prevailing and already going on in the villages, what are the problem of these programs, what are the remedial measures of this program, and what problem we have to face, and third is in what is the future need of this program. I just giving one example of, suppose a land is saline land in a particular village, and we have no idea about the past experiences, entire village is a saline due to the salinity of the water. We cannot have any ideas, we cannot make a program based on the land, for the program cannot be achieved the success, because we have not taken of the past experience about eradication of the problem of the salinity of the soil. We must take care of, and therefore, three situations plays a very important role in implementation of this program, that is past experiences, present situation and future. Should have a clear and significant objective which could satisfy the important need of the people. Sir, objective must be a very clear, whether we would like to have informative objective or we must have a persuasive objective, that must be a very clear. What is your aim and objective? If really you want to just pass your time and fill the vacuums, then only pursue this matter, pass on the information and your things are over. But really if you are interested that I would like to enhance the awareness about the farming community, my aim and objective is to improve the socio-economic status of the farming community, then you must use a persuasive objective. And what is the need of the people? Need means there are two type of things, gap between what is and what ought to be. At present, what is the situation and what ought to be, what we want to change. This is a gap between what is and what ought to be, is a need. What is the need of the people? At present, what is the status and where they want to go? If you find out this is a gap, then only when your program seems to be a very successful, and therefore, need must be identified prior to implementation of this program. Third, should it fix the priorities on the basis of available resources and time? Before implementing of the program, we must gather so many of the problems come across, and some of the problems they are based on the felt need, some of them are based on the unfelt need. We have to give some priorities to the problem. Which problem is facing a lot of problem for the farming community, we must tackle first. How long it will take to solve our problem, we must take first, and therefore, we have to give the priorities to the problem based on availability of the resources. I want to solve the problem, but I do not have any resources, and therefore, with a limited time also, some problem require 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, I have a limited resources, I have to wind up and find out the solution of this problem and find out the remedial measures of this problem within 2 months, within 3 months, that can be taken care of. Clarity indicates the availability and utilization of the resources. We have already discussed in the modalities that there are certain parameters about the availability of the resources. Suppose there is an acute problem of shortage of the seed and fertilizer in the villages. They have no cooperative society in the villages. They are not getting any yielding variety of the seed in the villages. When the resources are not available in the village, how you can implement your program effectively? Before you are implementing and plan the program, you must find out what type of resources are available and how best we can use the resources in a systematic manner, and how best we can aware the announcement about the resources by the way of different subsidies that can be taken care of before implementing any program. Have a general agreement at various levels. Sometime what happen, before implementation of program, we must gather some meeting of all caste, creed and other beliefs in the villages. There are certain sociology and psychological parameters prevailing in the villages. Different caste peoples are there, different educational strata is there. There is different norms, tradition, ritual, verbal instructs are available. We must have a general consensusness among us the villagers. Then only when the program must be achieved the success in which we can implement in a very systematic manner. Because without agreement among the masses, program may be good, but that cannot be achieved the success as which we are going to do. And therefore, consensusness at agreement at various level, right from top to bottom, is plays a very important role for development of a sound extension program and implementation of the program in a systematic manner. Involve people at local level. Sometime program are only related with the below poverty person or only for backward caste, even then we have to seek advice for the local dignitaries also. Local progressive farmers, political leaders also, otherwise program may be good, also provides subsistence to the farmers, but program will be later on failed because we have ignored the progressive person, local leaders, and therefore we must involve the people at the local level also. Then only when we can say this program can be effectively instituted or implemented in the village. Involve relative institutions and organization. There are certain institutions existing in the village. There are three village institutions in the villages like Panchayat Samiti, cooperative and village school. These are three are village institutions, and in every village the presence of village school is there, so that we can take a lesson to the students that can be transferred to the each and every house. We must have a cooperative society that can be, inputs are available through cooperative society, and village panchayat must be there in order to find out or eradication of any litigation, any dispute occurring in the villages. And these are the three village institutions. We must take care of the concurrence of these three institutions before implementing this program. And there are certain organizations also. Non-governmental organizations are there, government organizations are there, private organizations are there. We must take a consensus of these organizations. Okay, now these are our program, which we are going to implement in this village. What is your views? What is your parameters? How best you can assist in implementation of extension program for upliftment of the real economy? That can be taken care of while implementing or formulating of the village implement program. Have a definite plan of work. We must talk out our plan of work. How much time we have to complete this work? How much time required for analyze the situation? How much time for the find out the objectives? How much time it required to gather the problems? How much time to find out the remedial measures of the program? And therefore, a systematic plan must be chalked out. How much time it required to complete this program in a systematic manner, and therefore plan of work is an important parameter for any extension program in future strategy also. Provide for evaluation of results and reconsideration of the program. When the program is already going on, we must have a monitoring and supervision of the program on the way when the program is already going on. But when the program is about to wind up, we must have an evaluation study for what are the future weaknesses about this program, what are the drawbacks, what are the benefits of this program, so that if the program achieved the success, we can implement same program in another areas also. And therefore, the evaluation and reconsideration of the program, if there is any shortcoming in the program, we must reconsider. Can now these are the shortcoming which come in way, how best we can find out the remedial measures of this program, and we can implement the program in another district also through the thorough consideration of the program. Provide for adequate distribution of the benefits among the member of community. When in previous we have also agreement, general agreement of all level of person in the entire community as a whole. Suppose we arouse some of the benefits out of this program that can be equally distributed among all the community members of the program and without any unbiasedness. Because if there is nepotism and biasness among the program, it is very difficult for the extension worker to implement the any extension program in the villages, because all farmers are foresightedness. They have ideas about what type of benefit we have already received, and therefore benefits must be among us equally distributed to among the member of the entire committee as a whole. Then only when we can in a position to implement the program in future also. Nature of program planning process. There are certain nature of program planning. What type of program planning is? Is an educational process and involve both teaching and learning. Teaching and learning are two types of the things in which educational program, therefore that can be enhance the awareness among the farming community. That is educational. They provide some education infrastructure, that provides some knowledge, that provides some skill, then changing the behavior also, and provide changing the attitude also. And therefore, the teaches skill to the people of finding, analyzing, deliberating and focusing problem it. Teaches fact, that is gives more knowledge and change the attitude of the people towards the planning process. In under the program, we must provide some knowledge to the rural masses. What type of program is, how best we can achieve, and how we can transfer to the our friends also. We can have change the attitude of the program. Attitude is a degree. It is a degree of positive or negative. Sometime attitude may be negative, sometime attitude may be positive towards, but the program must be associated in some psychological object. That is the attitude. And attitude is being measured in a 5-point or 3-point continuum, whether the program is best or so-so or excellent. That is a perception of the farming community. We must program, we must find out the attitude of the program towards the program planning, and therefore we can say it is an educational program. And unifying and integrating the process of the people, get a total picture of where they are, where they shall do, and where they are likely to reach. We have to integrating the process. Before, we have already discussed what is the past experiences, what is the present experiences, and what is the future experiences. That can be clearly identify the rural masses. That is, our programs must be in what to reach and how best we can achieve the target in toto. And therefore, integration of different people, program by the people, for the people, with the people, that can be taken care of. And lastly, there is a coordinating process. So many of the programs of far-reaching significance are already on the way. And we must coordinate all the program in the villages so that farmer may not get confused. Clientele system must be benefited by coordinating the process of the program, require the coordination of the efforts and activities between the officials, non-officials, between institutions, organization, between people, materials and other likes. Therefore, there must be a effective coordination among all the participants, all the institutions, non-governmental organization, governmental organization, participants, officials. If there is a effective positive coordination, then only when we can say this is a very excellent program in a systematic manner. And therefore, coordination and cooperation plays a very important role for developmental and implementation of the program very effectively. Then evaluating process. Every program must need a monitoring and supervision and evaluation process. Evaluation comes under the 4-5 stages. We can have a date yourself evaluation, scientific evaluation, third party evaluation, various type of things are there. We can find out evaluation value, to judging the value of something is an evaluation. What is the value of this program? And there are certain method of evaluation, scientific evaluation. Evaluation of accomplishment is not the only creation, but also provide the evaluation of planning process and organization. Evaluation plays a very important role right from formulation of the program, their process of program, and their implementation of the program. And therefore, there are certain methods to be involved also, and the farmers can be actively participated right from implementation of the program till final adoption of this program. Today in this part of program, we have studied the program planning, principles of program planning. Program planning comes under the 4 statements. We have to analyze the situations, find out the objectives, identify the problem, and find out the suitable remedial measures of this problem based on the available resources. If the things are in systematic way, we can develop the effective program. But before implementing the program, there are certain principles of the program, like time-bound program, flexibility in the program, management scheme also, collaborative scheme also, cooperation and coordination is also, agreement is also. Certain principles are there, and principle can be implemented through various educational process. Different educational process are there, and implementation of the program and formation of the program, we must need a participation of the clientele system. And if any program is effectively evaluated by different agencies, maybe scientific evaluation, maybe third party evaluation, maybe do it yourself evaluation, by generalized evaluation, then only we can find out what are the bottlenecks, what are the formalities, what are the shortcomings of this program. If the program is seems to be a very successful, agreement amongst the different parameters, different from the top to bottom, definitely we can shift this program in another villages also. This is about, if we take care of all the procedure, then only when we can write from formulation till implementation, program must be plays a very important role in development of the rural masses in drought.